snow-thatched roof of the world, clutched in the slumber of centuries. Rolling away mile after mile, open space and sky blend in the far horizon. Only the Arctic Sea, choked with drifting ice, stirs sluggishly, its currents slowly, incessantly circling the North Pole. Little by little, man is opening up the bleak, neglected far north. Here, a Canadian icebreaker, directed by helicopter, leads an annual supply convoy toward a remote Arctic outpost. The copter pilot receives a warm salute from the Eskimos as he wings over Resolute Bay, the tiny defense and weather station deep within the Arctic Circle. Landing barges serve as moving vans, while natives watch the white man's ways with amusement and wonder. Though living in a harsh climate, the Eskimos are a friendly, contented people. Powerful equipment speeds the unloading, which is not without mishap. The busy harbor activity washes a white whale up on the beach. The Eskimos are eager to pull it ashore, for whale meat is a tasty delicacy. But their efforts end up a flop. Weather balloons are sent up hourly into the atmosphere where many of our worst storms are born. To the Canadian and American servicemen at Resolute Bay, life is a log of vigilance, work, and loneliness. This land of all-night sun in summer, so rich in natural resources, has long slept remote and invulnerable. Nomadic Eskimos, like their ancestors before them, still roam the frozen tundra, unaware that the desolate expanse hoards immense wealth in iron, oil, gold, platinum, and most important of all, strategic uranium. They do, however, work the coal seams that dot the region. Trudging across the snow, the Eskimos are headed for the oldest mine in the Arctic. The open coal veins on a cliffside near Baffin Bay were first tapped by whaling crews in the 1850s. The Eskimos hack away with picks to loosen the coal, which is free for the taking. After being shoveled up, the coal is screened into bags, which are then lowered by rope to waiting sleds, made by packing mud and ice onto wooden runners. Eager youngsters ignore the bitter cold as they drag the bags toward the sleds. The hardships of a crude little mining operation give graphic proof that man is not yet ready to claim the underground treasures of the Arctic. But explorations must go on. Dangerous voyages into shivering wastes where walruses at play are the lone sign of life. The helmsman is steering a course through the Northwest Passage, touched upon in last month's news magazine. Now, in these just released films, comes the complete story of that historic expedition. Navy frogmen wearing watertight exposure suits strike out to probe the freezing currents and to collect data on their flow. Without the protective suits, the men could not survive 5 minutes in the icy sea. The ship's helicopter seems but a speck as it drones over the face of a towering wall of ice. On all the Earth, only the Antarctic is less known, less accessible than this frosty Arctic frontier with its pocked and wrinkled face. The icebreaker Burton Island is knifing through treacherous ice packs that have blocked the Northwest Passage around the North American continent for thousands of years. The Arctic yields grudgingly to the powerful thrusts of the ship. The ice grows thicker and thicker. Finally, the Burton Island can push no further and groans to a stop. The ship's officers quickly order demolition crews sent out to dynamite a path of escape. The men must work quickly. Every minute reduces the chances of blasting free. Scientists capitalize on the crisis to gather more information on the ice packs, drilling out samples for later study. The ship rides higher and higher in the vice-like grip of the Arctic as the crew lowers the dynamite into place. The men are tense, waiting, waiting. She's free! And back on board, the men can chop away the coating that forms in a twinkling when temperatures plummet to 90 below zero. The Burton Island resumes its voyage. The worst is behind. Cameramen from a precarious perch capture vivid scenes of an untouched expanse, unmatched in frigid beauty. Though the ice packs are still there, they no longer imperil the ship as it churns ahead on the final leg of its epic 500-mile journey. Mission completed, it links up with another icebreaker, and the officers tell of their pioneer voyage through the Northwest Passage. And so it is that the Arctic frontier, roused from its slumbers, is receding. For man today, more ardently than ever before, is reaching into the eternally frozen top of the world.